Right, so this is another chapter, and this is a chapter in the name of advanced techniques in Rhino, and we will now explain the shell and shell surface. So let's get started by making a cube. So this is the cube, which is here, and we will go from this direction. And let's now we have make this, you can call this as a rectangle, or it's similar to a cube. So let's get started by making another circle, or a sphere, I mean. And this sphere will be in the center from here. We pick the center and draw a sphere, such as this. And after that, we will combine these two objects. And we can say union, and going here and say boolean union. So we have this shape, and so I think that we have now one shape. Alright, so let's going in for views and drawing an plane, or let's draw a line from here. And we will select this object and split it by this cutting edge, and click enter. So we have these two. We can hide this for now, and we have this shape. So we will offset the surface. So I will select this surface and click or type in the command bar offset SRF, and it say which direction. So we will flip by using F or click here. So we flip direction to make some thickness. And this is similar to the modifier in Blender, which is called the solidify modifier, and you can refer to other courses on Blender. And we have explained the solidify modifier in details. And now we will say that the distance will be maybe 3 millimeter, and the solid, yes. So we want to make the cab to be closed. So let's click enter to see what we will get. So we get this item, and it seems to be perfectly and no errors. So let's check by going to analyze and edge tools and show edges, and we will in a moment see that we should see this menu. So we will go to the edge tools and analyze or show edges. Alright, so we should go, let's close this now. We should go to the analyze and edge tools and show edges, and select the surface and click enter. We will see this panel. So the edge color will be maybe purple or something you may notice in the viewport. And we should use the second option, which is the next object, edges, and click zoom. So we have one edge which is we should fix now. This edge isn't perfectly aligned to our scene. So how we can fix this? In a moment, I will show you. So let's close this for now, and I will explode the object and extract the surface, and using the sweep to a rail, and first rail, which is here, and second rail, I think, which is here, and the edge, I think we have selected the. So let's go again, surface sweep to rails. We will select this rail, and selecting this other rail, and click cross section which is here, and click enter. All right, and we will see that this is the panel, and we click OK. You can rebuild with more control points, maybe 7, and click OK. And after that, I should join all of these by using the join tool. And after that, we can go select this object and analyze and edge tools and show edges. And it seems that we have another edges here. So why these problems? These problems weren't shown previously. So all right. So I think because the merging limit. So I will move 5 unit here, or maybe 45, to see what we have. All right, we have the surface already, but I think that the merge limit isn't so close to our. Right, so now we have no naked edges because I have closed all surface. So why? Where is the problem? The problem where is that we haven't selected all surface. So let's explain that. So I have selected this surface and click explode, and there is some surface here, but I didn't click all the object. So if I click all this, not the all, and click join, we have already some naked object. Let's select this and click zoom, add object and zoom. But if we select all and join, then we have no, we should have no object after joining. Because let's go to analyze again. And I think the only edge which is here, because this isn't closed, so we can join here, and no naked edges, so add object. The only edge which is flying here, and we can solve this issue in the next lesson.